Hey, what's up guys, this is Casey here, welcome back to another video, and today I'm going to be showing you guys how to make a detailed shirt in 2022. So this is obviously my most updated tutorial yet, and I've gotten a lot better since my last tutorial. And if this video helps you, make sure to like and subscribe, and yeah, let's get right into it. Okay, so we're going to be using Photopea. It's completely free. You don't have to download anything. So the first thing you want to search up is Roblox shirt template. And find one that has like the checkers, it's a PNG. And make sure when you're just on the page like this, it looks white. But then when you click on it, it turns to like the checkers. So yeah, just right click, copy image, and control V to Photopea. And now what we're going to do is we're going to just get a free shading template. There's my YouTube video right there. Roblox shirt shading. I think that should be good. And then there's a lot. I think this one looks pretty good. But I mean, there's multiple that look really good. So just do whatever you think is best. So yeah, copy that again. And again, make sure it has the checkers on it when you click on it. All right, control V, and then you wanna left click and hold and drag it under background. So now we have shading. Okay, now what we're gonna do is we're going to go down to this rectangle, and we're just going to go like this, and then can change the color to whatever color you want. This, I don't know, we can always change it. And then you wanna go to layer, then raterize. And now when you move layers, you wanna make sure you go back to like the mouse button. And now drag and hold under everything. So now it should look like this. So now we're getting some good progress. Now, we're going to add some detail to it. So like Roblox, not Roblox, just search up ribbed material. Yeah, get one of these and make sure it's like pretty straight. Just, you might have to look around a little. And again, this part isn't essential, but it will make it look a lot better. Okay, I think I'll go with this one. So yeah, just, I mean, it doesn't have to be perfect. So now, hit background, just do whatever the top layer is, control V. Now, you should have this. So now we're gonna go up to edit, go to transform, go to scale, and we are going to scale this to like right around there, I'd say. And this is probably a little too big, but yeah, drag this under everything except the red, obviously. All right, so we're gonna make this a little shorter, so say about right here. It's hard to get it perfect. Can always change it. Actually, I'm gonna drag it up to the top again. And what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go to rectangle select. I'm gonna drag and hold over the layer to the ribbed material. Then I'm gonna do control C. Okay, so now once you selected that and you copied it, now you just want to do rectangle select and just click off of it. Okay, now what you want to do is move it under the shading right here. That looks pretty good. And now what you want to do is match up the color. So go to image, then adjustments, then hue/saturation. And just try to get it close as possible. Okay. All right, so I'm getting pretty close. All right, I'd say that's pretty good. Okay, now just hit okay. And now actually, my bad, you're gonna have to copy it again since you changed the color. So just drag that on top. Now rectangle, select the whole rib material again. Just drag them under the shading again. Okay, so now just do Control V and one should be pasted, and drag it on top of that one. Okay, so now we're just going to place this across the bottom. Like this. And also, I think I'm doing an alright job, but if I'm not doing a good job of like describing how Photopea works, you can just watch a tutorial on, you know, just the basics of how to use Photopea. So now what I'm doing is I'm making it for the sleeves, and I'm going to make it a little smaller. This is fine for now. That looks good. Right here. Alright. Now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to take rectangle select and do it to about right here. And I'm going to go to just pretty much all the layers like that are below this part and do Control X and just do that for the shading as well and do it for the rib material. You have to select each one of them, but just make sure there's like nothing below that. And actually that's probably a little too long, so what I'm going to do is I'm just going to drag each one of these up a little. Okay, so that looks good. Just going to do this and Control X with the shading and then the orange. Alright, so that looks good. It's a good length. So now we got a lot of the details done, and I actually kind of messed up because you can see I like cut the shading too close. So to go back, just click these. So I'm going to do that again, and you can zoom in. All right, so right here is good. Control X, Control X. That's still a little. Alright, that's good. So now, to the area, pixel to pixel. Alright, so that looks good now. And this is probably the hardest part right here. Making, like, the collar part, the neck hole. Because what we gotta do, to make it detailed, we're gonna use this and get it just like a good size that you feel is right. Probably like that. Okay, so and then you can drag it and try to make it even as possible. Also, if it's like automatically snapping to the center, you can undo that. Because, it won't actually be centered. Alright, so I'm going to zoom in right here. And I'm going to just change the color for a second. Obviously, going to change it back. So I'm going to zoom in. Alright, so that looks good. So I'm going to go from here. from here and just make sure each side is 35 pixels, or it doesn't, just make sure both sides are even. All right, so they are. So that's good. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going back, going to go back to the shape. I'm going to go on fill and click here, and then I'm going to click on the orange part. I'm going to make it slightly darker. Actually, I'm probably going to brighten it a little. All right, that looks pretty good. So now what we're going to do is we're going to make the hole. So we're going to zoom out again. It's kind of hard to see. We're going to make it even as possible. Let's see how this looks. Make sure to do that. And now we're going to make sure each side is equal again. 45. And 45, okay. So I'm just pretty good at eyeing stuff out. I mean, that's not the best neck hole ever. I think I'll actually redo that. Alright, so let's try that again. It's just like, I don't know, I didn't like it. I'm gonna, oh shoot, I didn't mean to do that. Okay, I'm gonna actually drag it down a little more. Let me just double check to make sure the sides are even. Alright. Okay, so now I'm going to try this again. Go here and you right click to get the circle select. At first, this is kind of hard to get used to. But once you get the hang of it, it's fun. Okay, so 42. Alright, well, it's one pixel uneven, but I'll live with it. That looks pretty good. If you want to be real detailed about it and add like ribs in the collar, you can right click here and do like a line. Like that. But it does quite take a few minutes to do. So let's see how that would look. All right. Yeah, I mean, I guess I'll do it. Go back, fill it, make it a little darker. Maybe a little lighter. Raise your eyes. Okay, and I'm gonna scale it a little. I'm gonna cut it so it's not like. Okay, so that looks good. Now I'm gonna select that part again. Control C, Control V. And I'm just going to rotate it a little and, you know, make the collar more detailed. Right here, and I don't want it to go into the shirt collar, so I'm just going to do that. Okay, go back to shape 3 and copy the original one. Right there. Okay, and then for the first layer I did, I'm gonna move it right here so it looks a little better. Control V, put right on top there. Okay. So that looks pretty good. And now we're going to add a logo, but I mean, we're pretty much done just like for the base of the whole thing. The only thing we need to add now are just some logos if you want. VLAN logo PNG. So yeah, we'll just go with we'll go with this one. Copy image. Oh, also, I would like to mention, like, I'm not going to use this. Like, if it had a background, you can just go here and remove the background. Or you can go here, select color range, then go like that and remove it. So, yeah, but I'm not going to be using that logo. All right, so let's just do this. Let's put it under the shading. Gonna change the color of it. Alright, so let's search up orange VLAN key just to get some inspiration, I guess. I guess I can make it a white logo. Wait. Use saturation, do that, and then that. Yeah, that looks pretty good, actually. VLAN logo PNG again. All right, so we'll just use this. Drag it. Actually, I don't really need to drag it, I guess. That'll look all right. Okay, I'll do that right there. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to zoom way here. I'm going to do the lasso select, so I can just go like this. All right, that's good. And now I'm going to change it to white. Do that and click off of it. Okay, that looks pretty good. So now let's go to file, export as PNG, and then let's go to create or manage items if you got a group. Wait for it to load. Okay, so now choose file. Just upload that file. We're gonna call it orange VLAN T. Do that. Click on it, and it'll take a while to like upload to Roblox. But there you have it. Looks very nice. Got the V back there. It looks even and everything. Now I'm gonna just put it on sale. Sales on for sale 5. All right, and there you have it. Like I said, it'll take a while to completely upload to Roblox. So yeah, again, if this video helped you, make sure to like and subscribe, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Goodbye.